Now we'll take a look at three examples of determining outputs and inputs of rational functions. Here we're given f of x equals negative 16 divided by the quantity x minus 2. Instead of leaving this negative out to the left, I'm going to go and take the opposite of the numerator and write this as negative 16 divided by the quantity x minus 2. And now to evaluate f of negative 6, negative 6 is the input, so we'll substitute negative 6 for x. So f of negative 6 is equal to negative 16 divided by the quantity x minus 2, or negative 6 minus 2. That'd be negative 16 divided by negative 8, which is equal to positive 2. So f of negative 6 equals positive 2. Next, we're asked to determine x, the input, when f of x, the output, is positive 3. Which means now we'll substitute 3 for f of x and solve for x. So we want to solve the equation 3 equals negative 16 divided by the quantity x minus 2. We could write this 3 as 3 over 1 and then cross multiply to solve for x, or we could multiply both sides of the equation by the least common denominator, which would be x minus 2. Let's go ahead and do that. Either way, the result is going to be the same. Notice on the left side, we just have 3 times the quantity x minus 2, which would be 3x minus 6. And on the right side, x minus 2 over x minus 2 simplifies to 1, leaving us with negative 16. So we would add 6 to both sides. That'd be 3x equals negative 16 plus 6 is negative 10. Now divide both sides by 3, and we have x equals negative 10/3. So if f of x equals 3, then x must equal negative 10/3. Next we have g of x equals the quantity 13x minus 2 divided by the quantity x plus 2. So to determine g of 2, we'll substitute 2 for x. So g of 2 would be equal to the quantity 13 times 2 minus 2 divided by 2 plus 2. So we have 26 minus 2, that's 24, divided by 2 plus 2, that's 4, and 24 divided by 4 is equal to 6. So g of 2 equals 6. Next, we want to determine x when g of x, the output, is 12. So we'll substitute 12 for g of x and solve for x. So we'd have 12 equals the quantity 13x minus 2 divided by the quantity x plus 2. So now we have two options. We can form a proportion by putting 12 over 1 and then cross multiplying, or multiply both sides of the equation by x plus 2. X plus 2 over x plus 2 simplifies to 1. So on the left side we just have 12 times x plus 2, that would be 12x plus 24. We're distributing here, and on the right side we just have 13x minus 2. So to solve for x, we need x on one side. Let's go ahead and subtract 12x on both sides. This worked out nice because here we have 24 equals just x, or 1x, minus 2. Add 2 to both sides, and we have x equals 26. So if g of x equals 12, x equals 26. Now for the last example, we have p of t equals negative the quantity t plus 70 divided by the quantity 40 minus 3t. We need to be a little careful about this negative sign here. If we want to move this up to the numerator, we'd have to take the opposite of the numerator, or write this as negative the quantity t plus 70 divided by 40 minus 3t. We can't just make this t negative, because then we wouldn't be taking the opposite of this fraction or making this fraction negative. And now for p of 4, we'll substitute 4 for t. So I'm going to use this form here, so we'll have negative and then the quantity 4 plus 70 divided by 40 minus 3 times 4. So here we're going to have negative 74 divided by, this is going to be 28. This does simplify. There's a common factor of 2 here. So this simplifies to negative 37 over 14. So P of 4 equals negative 37 fourteenths. And then finally we're asked to determine T when P of T equals 2. So we'll substitute 2 for P of T, giving us the equation 2, or if we want 2 over 1, equals, I'm going to use this form again, so the opposite of T plus 70 divided by 40 minus 3T. Again, we could cross multiply or multiply both sides of the equation by 40 minus 3T. On the left, if we distribute, we would have 80 minus 6T. On the right side, this simplifies to 1, so we have the opposite of T plus 70. To clear the parentheses though, I'm going to think of distributing a negative 1. So it's going to be negative T minus 70. Let's go ahead and add 6T to both sides. So this would be 80 equals, this would be 5T minus 70. Add 70 to both sides, that would give us 150 equals 5T. Divide both sides by 5, we have T equals 30. So if P of T equals 2, then T equals 30. I hope you found this helpful.